Today you will hear ghost stories thrilling you through. And then witches and spooks will be spoken of too. But don't be afraid. It's all done in fun. For twilight's the time when these tales are spun. They walked down each lane, avenue, and street, rang every doorbell, and said,
"Trick or treat!"
But just when the children thought they were done, the princess said, "We've forgotten just one." So they walked to the house on the top of the hill, which gave all the kids a spine-tingling thrill. They stood on the porch and were ready to knock when they heard heavy footsteps and the turn of the lock. When what to their curious eyes should loom but a wicked cape, how it shimmered. Her face, how scary. Her hat was so pointy, it frightened the fairy. The Wicked Witch said,
"Welcome, we have a surprise."
And the children yelled,
"Run, it's not a surprise."
The monsters were sad when the kids ran away. They wanted the children to come in and play. The Wicked Witch said, "We can have our own fun. Come on, little monsters, the night's just begun." The monsters all cheered as they danced with delight. Happy Halloween to all, and to all a frightened night.
Thank you.
In the town of Littleton, Colorado, there was a house that everyone knew was haunted. It was an old, neglected house on a side street in the oldest part of town. Sometimes, the most wonderful smells issued from the house and filled the street with the heavenly odor of fresh baked bread. Whenever that happened, people would say that the old house must have been a bakery, or at the very least, the former home of a fabulous baker. Sometimes the neighbors would hear the sound of music and laughter coming from the empty house, as if there was a wonderful party in full swing. Whenever that happened, the neighbors would look at each other and say, "Wow, sounds like a nice party. I wish I was invited." Whatever ghost haunted the old house, they were friendly ghosts. But even the friendliest spirits are scary, and no one ever actually went inside the house, with the possible exception of a young boy or girl being dared by their friends. No one ever stepped foot on the front porch. One day, a man moved into town from a distant city. He saw the empty house and asked the neighbors who owned it. He was told that the owner was unknown and that the property could be bought for bad taxes. No one told the stranger about the house's curious history. The man went to City Hall, purchased the property, and soon after he and his family had moved in, strange things began to happen. Odd noises in the night. Weird lights drifting from room to room. The smells of baking from a cold kitchen. And worst of all, the sound of a party when the new owners were trying to sleep. After a few days, the man's wife declared she could no longer live in so haunted a place, taking the children with her. She moved out. Before long, the man gave up as well. He and his family found another place to live, but he was angry at the neighbors for not warning him about the house's reputation. He was angry at the town board for not telling him that the house was occupied by ghosts. In fact, he was angry at everyone in the neighborhood for treating him so badly. So he went to the mayor to complain and see if he could get his money back. The mayor refused, saying he never misrepresented the house as anything it was not. Just because a house is haunted, he said, doesn't mean you can't live there. The trick is to make friends with the ghosts, learn how to get along with them. So the man went to the pastor of the local church and told him his problem. The pastor said, "Wait a minute, you've been in town for a month, and only now when you're having a problem do you come to see me. Well, sit down and tell me what's on your mind." So the man sat and told the pastor about the haunted house he bought. Now, the pastor of this church was considered a wise man, set his ways, conservative in his manner and beliefs. He wasn't open to new ideas, but reluctantly agreed to visit the house to see exactly what the man was talking about. The pastor accompanied the man to the house. As they approached the lot the house was on, the pastor smelled something delicious. "Wow, what's that wonderful smell?" he said. "It's the ghosts baking bread," the man replied. When they got closer to the house, the pastor stopped to listen. He turned to the man and inquired, "I hear beautiful music. Is somebody having a party?" "It's the ghosts having a party," replied the man. They went inside and looked around the empty house. The pastor sat at a table while the man looked for something to serve his guests. There was beer in the refrigerator, so he poured a glass for the pastor himself. They toasted each other's health and drank. So you moved from Denver to Littleton, said the pastor. My parents live in Denver. I know the neighborhoods there well. The man, it turned out, knew something of the pastor's relatives. They talked and joked about these things that they had in common and felt a friendship growing. They were having such a pleasant time that before they knew it, several hours had passed. They were gone so long, the man's wife began to get nervous. "I went to the pastor's house hours ago," she said to herself. "Maybe the ghost got him." So she went to the pastor's house, introduced herself to the pastor's wife. Together, they cooled their misgivings about ghosts and their worries about their husband and walked to the haunted house together. They peeked into the windows and saw the two men sitting at a table, drinking, laughing, and having a good time. The wives joined them and found they had much to talk about. The laughing and talking attracted the neighbors, who stopped by and introduced themselves. Pretty soon, the kitchen was filled with the smell of cooking. A neighbor brought his vibraphone, and another brought his ukulele. And just like that, there was a party. The old house filled with real smells and real laughter. It was alive again, and that, of course, was all it wanted all along. From that day to this, the old house came alive again, and its ghosts were all laid to rest, never to be seen.